Hello, guys and gals. And for some reason, that was very slow starting up. Anyways, this is week 33 of our writing challenge. And as always, we're going to go over all the previous writing challenges. And there is a playlist somewhere where they're all listed and you can go over each different challenge. And apparently there's quite a few of them. 33 to be exact. Well, now 33. Anyways, this is our 75 subscribers special. And put these scissors away. I mean, scissors right here. I needed them earlier. And we're going to put those away because I don't want to end up forgetting about them and end up hurting myself on them. There we go. Anyways, so as you can see, it is 2:34 in the morning. So if this video doesn't turn out very well, then it's probably my own fault for putting it off. Anyways, enough of that. The writing challenge for week one was to create a setting, be as detailed or vague as you like. I won't have time to do this tomorrow, so I have to do this tonight. Writing challenge for week two was create two characters, be as detailed or vague as you like. Week three was create one final character, either a hero or a villain, be as detailed or vague as you like. I really like those words, didn't I? Luckily, I got rid of those later. Week four was create a time period. Any time period will do. Any technology will do. Be as detailed or vague as you like. Wow, I'm so glad I got rid of those. Those words are so annoying. Create one interaction between two characters. It doesn't need to be canon to the story. I finally got rid of those annoying words. Writing challenge for week six was create a climate or weather situation, i.e. a sandstorm, snowstorm, or rainstorm, etc., and explain it, and stuff like that. That was fun. Yeah, okay. Chapter for week seven, which I accidentally put as weck, and I had to slide another E in there. Look out one of your windows and describe what you see. Yes, yes, yes. Week eight was describe your favorite food. Week nine was describe your favorite mythical or fantastic creature. All creatures are fantastic to a certain extent. Writing challenge for week 10 was describe your favorite dinosaur. Behind was Parasaurolophus. I think I'm pronouncing that wrong. I don't remember exactly how it's pronounced now, but anyways, that's the way I pronounce it. Writing challenge for week 11 was describe your ideal vacation. That was always nice to think about. Writing challenge for week 12 was describe your favorite season. Week 13 was describe your favorite beverage. We are covering all of our bases here. And my voice is getting kind of ragged because I have basically read 3.5 hours worth of literature. The books are right there. And I always cram all of my videos into Sunday night. So it's like, okay, I need to really stretch those out. Anyways, writing challenge for week 14 was describe your favorite non-fantastic animal, which is kind of an oxymoron because all animals are fantastic to a certain extent. Writing challenge for week 15 was if you could visit any country, which one would you visit? Oh, writing challenge week 16 was our 50 subscriber special. Wow, that was, I don't know when that was, but it was around Christmas, I believe. And here we are at 75, so that's pretty good. Week 16 was describe something you are thankful for. Actually, if you think about it, that was 17 weeks ago. That's kind of cool. And for some reason, my phone is making weird noises. That's so fun. Writing challenge for week 17 was describe one of your hobbies. I think the best part of these videos is me complaining. Writing challenge for week 18 was describe one of your New Year's resolutions. Challenge for week 19 was describe your dream job. Mine was, I think, being a YouTuber. What was I thinking? Writing challenge for week 20 was describe your favorite genre of video game. Writing challenge for week 21 was if you had a magical toolbox that would always have one tool inside it, it would never be lost. Which tool would that be? That was kind of a fun one. I had been watching too much Doctor Who. Writing challenge for week 22 is if you could have one superpower, what would it be? Week 23 was describe your favorite holiday. Everybody loves holidays. Week 24 was describe your favorite superhero, not to be confused with superpower. Writing challenge for week 25 was if you could open a restaurant, what would you sell? Or serve, rather. That should probably be serve, not sell. Of course, either word is acceptable. Writing challenge for week 26 was, if you could form a band, what kind of music would you play? That sounds fun. Week 27 was, if you could write an epic story, what would it be about? Week 28, I accidentally wrote on. The pictures here go over here. And yeah, I was being kind of weird. That's what lack of sleep does. If you could change one event in the past, would you? That was week 28. That one was fun. Week 29 was, if you could design a logo that would represent your life, what would it look like? Well, it's over here, but yeah, whatever. I don't know what was happening that day. Writing challenge for week 30 was, if you could build your dream house, what would you build? Week 31 was, if you could tame any animal, either normal or fantastic, which would you tame? And we are to our last challenge, the challenge for last week. I should be prepared for this, but I'm not. Okay. Writing challenge for week 32. I was using a different pen, and it shows. This handwriting is terrible. If you could learn any language and speak it fluently, which language would you learn? Well, I would have to say some language that used symbols like Egyptian hieroglyphics. I would have to say Japanese. I mean, then I could understand all those special videos, you know, the ones, wink, wink. Then I could understand what they were saying, you know. Because a lot of those aren't exactly dubbed, and it's like, well, what are they talking about? Anyways, but in all seriousness, I would probably still say Japanese or Chinese just because it is a fascinating language. Probably one of the oldest languages in human history, to be honest. And it would be just fun to learn that. That or German. I might be of German descent, so maybe I should learn German. I'm not going to learn another language. I already know Spanish. Like, I took 4 years of it in high school, but I don't like really know how to speak it. I know conversational Spanish to a certain extent, but I haven't really used it, so I don't really remember any of it. But anyways, I would still have to say Japanese, basically just because I like anime and I'd like to actually see the whole, you know, what they're saying and not have to rely on, you know, what's been translated, because sometimes those translations aren't so good. I know people really try, but there's such a language barrier that sometimes the translations come out, you know, like all of your bases belong to us or whatever. All of your bases are belong to us. And, you know, there's always all those bad translations out there. So it'd be nice to know what people are saying. And yeah, the whole hentai thing was a joke, of course. Anyways, my jokes don't make any sense this late at night. Anyways, let's hopefully nobody heard that. Anyways, our 75 subscriber special, writing challenge for week 33, is, if you could meet one historical figure, who would it be and why? And I'm going to repeat this two more times, just basically because most fairy tales and, you know, stuff like that mention things repeated in threes. Which also, what was it called? Repo, the genetic opera, the Zydrate comes in a little glass vial, a little glass vial, a little glass vial. You see, everything is repeated three times because it's like, you know, easy to remember. Amber Swift is addicted to the knife, addicted to the knife, addicted to the knife. Yeah, I'm going to have that song stuck in my head all night. Zydrate, you know, Zydrate. I don't even remember what the title was, but it had something to do with Zydrate or something. Some kind of drug that they extracted from corpses. I don't know. I haven't actually even seen the movie. It's just that when I worked at Deranged, that's a story in itself. But back when I worked at Deranged, people would, you know, request that song, you know, so I'd hear it a lot. You know, Zydrate comes in a log last file. And it's such a catchy song, you know. Of course, I'm going to get copyright struck just for singing that little bit. But, I mean, I sang Radioactive by Imagine Dragons, and YouTube was like, well, hey, we don't care. They didn't even mention anything. So, hey, maybe I can actually sing. Anyways, I'm not monetized or anything anyway, so whatever. I don't even care. But anyways, yeah. And then it's like, grave robber, why do I even bother? Why do I even need you at all? You know, like that. But honestly, I don't really remember that. Anytime I think of that song, I think of Solidium. I mean, It was a song from Saw by Solidium. I don't remember what it's called. But it was based off of Saw 4 or something, or one of the Saw movies. And basically, in the music video, all the band members are like brutally mutilated by saw traps or something. It was really a weird video, but it had really a catchy tune. Anyways, now that I'm completely off track, I'll repeat this two more times. Writing challenge for week 33 is, if you could meet one historical figure, who would it be and why? I'm going to let that soak in for a little bit. And for the last time, writing challenge for week 33 is, if you could meet one historical figure, who would it be and why? And yeah, that outro wasn't exactly an outro. It was more of a sidetrack, side trip, a sidetracking side trip. That's there to see if anybody's paying attention and actually watching these. So anyways, if you have, then maybe you could say something in the description. Some kind of code word, like code word or something. Anyways, so yeah. Writing challenge for week 33 is, if you could meet one historical figure, who would it be and why? And that is going to do it for this video. If you like this content, make sure you like and subscribe, ring that bell so you know when I upload. Also, we have a Discord server that has like the weekly schedule, and you can actually see the schedule in advance instead of me, you know, instead of it popping up every so often, you know. You can be like, oh, well, on this day, he's going to be reading this book at 1 a.m. And on this day, he's going to be singing Imagine Dragons, Radioactive by Imagine Dragons. And on this day, he's going to be doing a movie review of Half Brothers. You know, stuff like that. The Discord is really, really nice, and the link should be in the description. And I'm not even sure if that link works, but maybe someday somebody will try it, and then we can see if it actually works. And if I need to get a new link, and maybe, I don't know, that's going to be a lot of work. Oh, gosh. Anyways, if you like this content, then I probably already said that. I did. Okay. Well, thanks for watching, everyone, and have a great day.